I would usually say my hometown or my neck of the woods, which I guess is quite a country way of saying it. Hey guys, it's Amanda. If you're new here, I'm an American living in the UK, and I post about my life and experiences living here, as well as these weekly reactions requested by all of you. I've spoken about the differences between English in the US and here a lot, and I came across this video and thought it was time to give it a go. So slang is probably one of my favorite things because it could mean anything, and chances are you wouldn't have a clue unless you're in the know. I don't know why I said it like that.
Very cool.
But what is your favorite slang term and why? Let me know in the comments.
Welcome to Eat, Sleep, Dream, English. Today we're looking at American slang versus British slang so that you can tell the difference between a quid and a buck and a manor and a hood. I can't wait, guys. Let's get going. All right, let's get going straight away. Now, I'm gonna give you the standard word and then I'm gonna give you the slang alternatives. All right, so let's get going with number one. Mouth is the standard word. In British slang, we have a lot of British slang words, but one way you can say mouth is cake hole. Cake hole, that's right. The hole where you put the cake. Now, what is that in American English?
Pie.
It's a pie hole, of course, a pie hole. I love it. A cake hole in British English and a pie hole in American English. Why? I don't know why. Just that's what we say, right? So, you might say this. Shut your pie hole, Tom.
You are?
I told you once, shut your pie hole. Okay? Shut it real good.
How very dare you?
Shut it.
How very dare you?
Shut your pie hole.
How rude are you?
Zip it.
I'll shut my pie hole when you shut your cake hole.
Shut your pie hole.
I'm not said that.
Okay, all right, enough. Fighting over here. So cake hole, British English, pie hole, American English. Okay, what about one single unit of money? Well, in British English, a pound is a quid, Q-U-I-D, quid. But in American English, one single dollar is a buck, B-U-C-K, a buck. So I might say, could I borrow a quid in British English? But in American English, you might ask for a buck. So can I borrow a buck? Do you guys have a slang term for one single unit of currency in your language? Let me know in the comments below. Okay.
I'm not actually sure why we say buck. I have to look that up. I'm really curious now, actually. Because I used to say that all the time. You got? Do you have a few bucks? If you know, if you happen to know, I don't know why you would. But if you do, put it in the comments.
House. Your house. In British slang, we might say gaff. Your gaff. In London, modern London slang, they might say man's yard. Man's yard. Now, this is very young. I personally wouldn't say it, but you might hear it if you're in London. In American English, a home or a house would be a crib. A crib. Like a baby, right? A baby starts off, we put them in a crib. That's the same as your house, right? So the slang term for house is crib in America. MTV had a TV program called MTV Cribs, and they took us around famous people's houses. So if it was in Britain, a remake, it would be MTV Gaffs. Doesn't quite sound so cool in British English. MTV Gaffs, not quite as cool, but anyway. Okay, an example sentence. There's a really nice park near my gaff, we can go there. There's a really nice park near my gaff, we can go there. Okay, let's take the word friend.
They are used in different areas of the US, but I mean, you never hear me say crib. Like, yeah, I think it's just used in different areas of the States.
Friend. Now, there are lots of alternatives for friend. It has lots of slang terms. In British English, we might say mate. That's the most common way to say it. So mate or bro is possible, or fam for modern London English. Fam would be used. In American English, you've got homie, and then you've got bro, which I think would be used in both American and British slang. Personally, I would never say homie. I've not really heard it used much in British English. There are lots of other alternative slang words for friend, but these are the main ones, right? So example sentence, all right, mate, how's it going? All right, mate, how's it going? Okay, your area. That's the standard word or neighborhood in American English. Well, in American English, neighborhood is shortened to hood. So your area, the place that you live, could be your hood. Now, I know that has certain connotations in America. So any American viewers watching, what other slang terms do you have for your neighborhood? Not just hood, but anything else. In British English, we would say manor. That's quite an old school word, your manor, so your area. Or in modern London slang again, your ends. Now these words have certain connotations and there's just definitely a certain tribal aspect to them. Like this is my manor. So like, you know, this is different from your manor. Like we're from two different places. Now, if you don't want to think like that in a kind of tribal way, then you could just say area. Just use the normal word, the standard word for it, which would be area, right? So if you don't want to use that kind of tribal language, then you could just use the standard form of area. So to be honest, I wouldn't say ends or manor. I don't see London like that. I don't see the city like that. For some people, that is important, okay? So, you know, it depends on who you are and what kind of language you want to use. If I was asking where someone was from, I would say, oh, what area are you from? Or maybe what neighborhood are you from? I might borrow the American English word. But I wouldn't say what manor are you from or what ends are you from. But some people do like to use those words. Okay, let's take the word tired.
I've definitely heard people say homie or bro or hood, things like that. But those aren't words that I would use, to be honest. And then, like you said, they are used in a particular sort of area. Usually, to be honest, they're closer to cities and things like that. Like if I was talking about where I lived, I would usually say my hometown or my neck of the woods, which I guess is quite a country way of saying it. But yeah, I guess, like you said, it just depends. Like the US is massive. It just depends where you live because there'll be so many words for different things, just like here. It's no different.
Tired. Now in British English, we would say knackered. Mate, I am knackered. Perfect word. I love that word. You might also say shattered as well. Oh, I'm shattered. In American slang, you're probably more likely to say beat. I'm beat. You know what? I'm beat. Man, I'm beat. knackered or shattered in British English, beat in American English. Okay, what about excited? Let's say you're going to a concert tonight and you're excited. In British slang, we would say buzzing. Oh, I'm buzzing for the concert tonight. I'm excited. You might say pumped as well. I'm pumped for the concert tonight. In American English, I think they would say hyped. I'm hyped or I'm amped. I'm amped. Hyped or amped. Now, of course, it is possible to use those in British English. I have heard them before. But I think generally speaking, we would use buzzing. That's the word that I hear most commonly. So example sentence, I'm buzzing about the concert tonight. I'm buzzing about the concert tonight. Okay, standard word is to share the bill. In British English, we would say to split the bill, right? So if the bill comes, you're like, should we split the bill, guys? Should we share it? In American English, they would say to go Dutch. So when the bill arrives, they would say, should we go Dutch? It means, should we share the bill? Now, again, that's something that you might use in British English, but probably you just say split the bill. Police officer. Now, in American English, it's a cop, right? It's a cop. But in British English, we would probably say copper or bobby as well. That's another term that you might hear. But yeah, copper. There are, of course, loads of slightly ruder terms. We won't go into those today, but yeah, cop to copper. Let's take the adjective angry. Angry. Now, in American English, they would just say, I'm pissed. I'm pissed. Slightly rude, okay? In British English, pissed means drunk. So we add a preposition to make it angry. So it's pissed off. You're pissed off. So man, I am super pissed off with my boss today. You would be angry at your boss. Okay, what about the adjective pleased? Pleased.
That was probably one of the things that was most confusing when I first moved here is pissed. Because like you said, it means completely different thing in the US. Like I just thought everyone here was really angry. Like all the time. But to be fair, obviously everyone's not. But it did make me laugh. I just think so many of these words, when they come up on the screen, I actually think about the British word before the American word. That's how long I've lived here. Mental.
If you're pleased, you're happy with something. In American English, they would be stoked. Sounds kind of like a surf term to me, like, yo, I'm stoked. Like, I just got a wave, I'm stoked. Okay, whereas in British English, you'd be chuffed, or chuffed to bits would be their full term. So, oh, I'm chuffed to bits, I caught a wave, I'm chuffed to bits. So yeah, the difference between an American surfer and a British surfer, one would be stoked, and the other one would be chuffed to bits. Okay, and finally, drunk, the adjective drunk. Now, there are hundreds of terms on both sides, American English and British English, for this. Let's talk about a few of them. So in American English, maybe wasted or trashed. Those are typically American that I think of. Whereas in British English, you might say wasted or trashed. Probably, though, you would say hammered, battered. Words like that. So yeah, a few differences there. Okay, are you ready for a quiz? Now I'm gonna give you a sentence and I want you to decide, is it British English or American English? Good luck.
I thought Tom was really informative. I'm going to have a look at some of his other content. Now, as for American versus British slang, I love it. We both use so many words for the same thing. And I think slang is what makes moving to the country really confusing, but incredibly fun. Don't you agree? Well, let me know what's your favorite British or American slang word and put it in the comments. And as always, if you haven't already, please subscribe to my channel, smash that like button if that's what you're into, and I'll see you in the next video.